What's going on, everybody? Welcome to part 24 of the Intermediate Python series. In this tutorial, what we're going to be talking about are the string and wrapper methods, or the dunder string, dunder wrapper methods. So these two methods are very similar, and a lot of times people ask, like, what's the main difference? In reality, you really can get by just with the wrapper method. But in general, the dunder string method is meant to be like a human readable description of your object, and then the wrapper method is really, it's still human readable-ish as long as someone's usually familiar at least slightly with your object. But also the wrapper method's more meant for just kind of debugging purposes, not really to be something that you would actually show somebody in production or something like that. But they are interchangeable to a degree, and a lot I've seen people that just simply have a wrapper method, they don't even bother with a string method. So what exactly do they do? Well, first of all, we can show a quick example with a module that exists and everybody has it, and we're going to do the date time module. So you can either follow along or just you can follow along in code or just kind of watch. This part won't really be necessary that you code with me. So I'm just going to run this real quick just so we can get into a shell. I'm going to import date time, and then if I do something like this, date time dot now, and I'm going to go ahead and copy this so I don't have to keep writing that 1,000 times. If I just hit enter here, what we get is the wrapper method, because we're just referencing the object. We haven't asked this object to, say, be printed, which would give us the string representation. So just printing it, or just stating the object in a shell like this, returns the wrapper method, as opposed to printing it will by default give us the string method. If there is no string method, it will give us the wrapper method. So if there was no string method, we would actually just see this. But the other way you can be certain of this is you could just do wrapper, quite literally, paste, and there you have that. And also you could use string, and there you have that. Now, what about with our blobjects, right? And I guess also, like, why would you want to have string and wrapper methods? Like, what's the whole point? Well, at least by default, the string and wrapper methods, or at least what you'll have right now, which is a wrapper, is worthless. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is copy these lines. And now you do want to be following along. If you don't have this code, like if you're just hopping into this tutorial, go to pythonprogramming.net, go to the Python fundamentals, part 24, and copy and paste the code. It'll be kind of near the top of the script. So now what we're going to do is, since we've got the code here, let's go ahead and run this. Pretty sure I hit run. There we go. We're just hanging for a second. And now let's print blue blobs, and we'll just reference the zeroth blue blob. What we get is absolutely useless, right? And again, this is clearly a wrapper method if you're familiar, but chances are you might not be. But anyway, we'll just do it again just to see. Okay, so yeah, we're definitely dealing with just a wrapper, and as you can see, this default wrapper method is useless. So what we might want to do is actually make our own, and we saw at least one example of why you would want to do this in the previous tutorial, like when we were logging for debugging purposes. So it can be really useful if your methods actually, or if your objects actually have string and wrapper methods. We didn't at the time, but now we're going to add some. So let's close this. And now what I'm going to go ahead and do is head on over to the actual blob.py. So this is what we're actually importing. This is our blob class, the base class anyways, or the parent class. We are modifying that up here with the blue blobs and the red blobs and the green blobs. But we don't have to give each of these their own wrapper method. We actually just need, we could just do it in this parent class here. So what I'll do is just come down here, and now I'm going to go ahead and do a dunder wrapper. And we just need to pass self. We do need the other dunders though. And now what we're going to do is just, obviously it just returns a string, right? And like we were saying, the wrapper method is really more kind of for debugging purposes. It should be as condensed as possible. It's not really meant to be output to a console in production use. It's just really for debugging. So what we're going to do is we're going to return, and we'll return blob. And then the information we're going to give on this blob, basically it's going to be size, color, And then we'll do X and Y. Okay. So then we're going to do dot format and then self dot. And in fact, actually, we'll do color first because the color is more important. So we'll do self.color and then self.size, self.x, and self.y. So now we have repr method. Let's save that. Let's pop on over to blob world. Looks good. And now let's print blue blobs 0. And now at least we have something a little more useful. We've got the color. Again, this is an RGB. The size, and then the XY coordinates location. So someone who's actually familiar with these blob objects should be able to, when they see this in any sort of debugging, immediately know, okay, this has to be the color. I'm not certain what 6 is, but since we know these blob objects have a color, a size, and a location, I can just deduce that size. And then from here, these two things in parentheses, it's not totally clear what they are, but it's probably X and Y, right? And we could also go to the actual repr method just to see what it actually is printing out. But that's, you want to keep it as just simple as that. And just basically it's just for debugging purposes. And as you can see, because we did print, that should have been a string method. But since we don't have one, it's just going to fall back to the repr method. But if we said, if we just now referenced the object, we're not trying to reference the string method, it's still obviously the repr method. Now let's go ahead and add a string method. So let me pull it back up. Whoops, there we go. I'm just going to copy this because it's going to be very, very similar. It's just going to have slightly more information and just be easier to read. So change it to string now. Blob, you might say, you could either have like blob in parentheses, or you might get rid of even the parentheses here. And you could say like blob of color, something like that, and then comma size, and then location. And we'll tab these over just to be as close. It's probably not going to be perfect. Oh my goodness, it worked. That feels really good when that stuff happens. All right. It's going to be a good day. So now, let's save and run that. I hope I saved it. I think I did. Let me check before I waste time. Yep. Okay. So print now. Blue blobs 0. And again, this should be great. Yes, so we got the string version. And again, now if we do blue blobs 0, we get the repr version. As opposed to, obviously, print gives us the string version. So it just has a little bit more information, a little easier to read, but yeah, it's almost like twice as long. But now what we could do is if we close this, like when we go to our actual blobworld.py and we do things like logging, let me find the first log. Let's see, tried. Raise that exception, login in. So like here, blob add operation, and then we were doing the like, you know, string formatting, and we were just doing self.color. Well, instead, what we could say now is the string version of self and the string version of other blob, right? We don't have to reference any of the attributes because now we actually have something of use. We could also, we could say repr rather than string just to make our logging file even smaller, but I'll leave it there. And then again here, checking if two blobs are touching, this was that debugging. So like you could change that now because again, we were just using the color, but instead we could just do the actual blobs. And then I think we had another one down here, but yeah, I guess we're not doing it. So we could clear this, clear that. We can save this. And let's see, what was our logging? We're on info right now. And let me do an info just to... So when two add operations happen, we should see a new form of adding. I haven't seen any happen just yet. We will see one here. Yep. Okay. So hopefully we've got a new log there. Let's open the log file. And go down to the very, very, very bottom. And sure enough, we have slightly better information here now on our actual blobs. Obviously, we have a little bit more information. We might actually want to log the repr rather than the string version of the object. But yeah, anyway, just supposed to be an example of string and repr. I think I'll change these though. Repr, and then what was the other one? I must be zooming by it. Oh, here we go. Repr, and then this repr here. Okay, all is well in the world. Let's run that one just to see. Somebody needs to touch. These blues are touching. I'm pretty sure that'll still throw a log, even though that doesn't matter if they touch each other, the blue blobs at the moment. But I'm waiting for these to touch each other. So one of these guys got it. There we go. Whew, that's a big blue blob. He's going to be taken over soon. Okay. Now we'll check the log file again. Scroll on down to the very, very bottom. And it's a little more concise now. Whoops. There we go. Oh my goodness. There we go. Yeah, cool. So anyway, that's the string and repr methods. Just a couple more special methods that are really useful actually to know about, especially if you're writing your own classes and all that. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, something else you want to bring up, let us know below. Otherwise, I will see you in another tutorial.